strongest man, Mark Henry. Currently contesting schedule four, one fall, approaching the ring, weighing in at 353 pounds, the world's strongest man, Mark Henry.
Al, I'll tell you one thing right now, we have seen feats of strength from Mark Henry that have been spectacular in recent weeks. This man actually picked a 2.5-ton car 6 inches off the ground.
And took with his bare hands and rolled up a frying pan.
Like now, it was a newspaper.
Yeah, with the looks of him, I think he's used that frying pan for a little bit more than just rolling it up like a newspaper.
And from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing in at 265 pounds, the Godfather.
Not a good reaction for the Godfather here on Velocity this weekend. You know, the fans haven't quite liked the Godfather ever since he gave up the escort service a few months back.
Undoubtedly, but you've got to admit that he has become far more focused and far more aggressive since he doesn't have to worry about all of his ladies.
Well, the Godfather will have to be aggressive here tonight against Mark Henry. What a spectacular show we have on the way, including exclusive footage. What you missed with SmackDown went off the air this past Thursday night on UPN.
That was so cool. I can't wait to see it again.
Plus, we're going to show you folks the winners of Tough Enough 2, a very emotional and important night for Jake, Kenny, Jackie, and Linda live from the world this past Thursday night. I'll tell you, Tough Enough 2, what a season, and Al, what a finale, something that you were proud to be a part of this past week.
Oh, without a doubt, it was a big-time show, a big-time production, and it was what those kids deserved, all four of them, even the ones who didn't win.
You hear this crowd, they're chanting for the Godfather's ladies to be brought back, but there's the strength of Mark Henry and that infectious smile of the world's strongest man.
Well, you chant for the ladies to be brought back too, don't you, Michael?
Well, of course I would. It's Mark Henry and the Godfather. Look at Mark Henry just mocking the Godfather. I tell you, I don't know if that's wise against the man, the veteran caliber of the Godfather.
Wily cagey then goes to show, uses the experience to get the upper hand.
The big right hands by the Godfather to Mark Henry, also here in Velocity tonight, folks. And look at the near 400 pounder. And that's pure strength as the Godfather thunders off the turnbuckles. And you know, Godfather's no small man now.
No, he's close to 300 pounds himself.
Mark Henry back into the corner, ducks underneath the right hand of the Godfather. And here's Mark Henry yet again. Godfather at all times a trouble. Here tonight, we're going to talk to you about a serious issue that has developed between Triple H the Game and The Undertaker. Triple H telling The Undertaker, I want a shot at the Undisputed title. The Undertaker beating the hell out of The Game on SmackDown. It was an absolutely vicious assault. The Undertaker with those steel chairs this past Thursday night out.
He had to have hit him at least 15 or 20 times.
And look at Mark Henry. And Godfather, there is the veteran maneuver by the Godfather, taking advantage of Mark Henry, who's still learning the craft inside the squared circle.
It's like a human game of chess. Due to experience, Godfather's got the upper hand.
And he's doing the right thing here, wouldn't you agree, going to work on those big trunks of legs of Mark Henry?
Hey, you take out a point of balance. Take out the leg, because you're all the same size on the mat. Granted, Mark Henry may be the world's strongest man, but it don't help him a lot when he can't stand.
We're going to also take you back to SmackDown this past Thursday night and show you a surreal cage match between Kurt Angle and Edge, and how Hollywood Hulk Hogan got revenge on Angle and cost Angle the mat jumping. There's a thumb to the eyes by this very aggressive Godfather here on Velocity.
Right to the throat.
And the Godfather now with the boot to the throat. Al, if you're in there in the ring against the world's strongest man, what is the best way to combat Mark Henry?
Exactly what the Godfather is doing. Try to cut off his air or take out his legs.
Godfather, oh!
Don't let him stay on his feet and don't let him breathe.
What a shoulder knockdown. Here's the cover on Mark Henry and a kick out with authority. And I don't know if I've ever seen anyone manhandle the Godfather like that.
Like I said, Godfather's close to 300 pounds himself, and he threw him out of the ring.
Godfather seemingly embarrassed him, and he got knocked down by the clothesline of Mark Henry.
Almost knocked the braids out of his hair.
Godfather whipped across the ring, and Mark Henry with a vicious elbow to the chin of the Godfather. And I think Mark Henry senses this one may be close to being over.
Godfather's got to go back to the strategy that was working before.
Oh, no, not this. Godfather in a prone position. This is 350 pounds crashing
basically decapitated him.
And Mark Henry hearing it from this capacity crowd. And the Godfather, I don't think he knows where he is.
I don't think I'd know where I was, too. With Mark Henry just jumped on my head.
Godfather whipped across the ring yet again. The strength of Mark Henry. You could feel the ring shake out here at ringside.
Mark Henry, don't take the time. Don't take the time. You got him hurt.
Godfather to his feet. And look at this. The bear hug locked into the Godfather.
Can you imagine what that feels like?
And the Godfather's had it up. The referee calls for the bell. Mark Henry treating the Godfather like a rag doll.
Here's your winner, the world's strongest man, Mark Henry.
Absolutely impressive.
You're like a human vice just grabbing a hold of you and cracking your ribs.
The world's strongest man, Mark Henry, with a huge victory on Velocity this week. We're back on Velocity. We can tell you, folks, that tickets sold out in less than 2 hours for our show in Honolulu, Hawaii. Want to thank all our fans on the islands for their support. We get ready to see this man in action.
The contest is going to go for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Boston, Mass. Weighing in at 350 pounds, Albert.
Well, Albert looking to make a name for himself, and Mr. McMahon SmackDown has the opportunity to do it right here tonight on the brand new Velocity on TNA.
Well, tonight, Velocity is brought to you by the Flame Broil Whopper from Burger King, America's favorite burger. At BK, you got it.
And by 1-800-CALL-ATT for collect calls.
And by Hungry Man from Swanson, a whole pound of the good-hearted food men love.
I think Albert probably eats a lot of Hungry Mans.
I think he keeps them in business.
So does this guy.
Weighing in at 280 pounds, Hugh Morris.
Looking forward to this matchup, Al, because here you got two guys who really have an opportunity to make names for themselves within Mr. McMahon's SmackDown. Hugh Morris and Albert, two guys who really seem to have all the tools.
Hugh Morris, the human Humvee. He's got size, he's got strength. We got to kind of give him the edge as far as agility. But then you've got the North American Grizzly, Albert.
Well, folks, want to remind everybody, we talked about those tickets selling out less than 2 hours for the big show in Hawaii. Raw this Monday night, still plenty of good seats available in Dallas. And next week, SmackDown comes to you from Oklahoma City as Hugh Morris takes it to Albert. And you never know what's going to happen. What about this past Monday night on Raw, Al? Chris Benoit, who's actually the property of Mr. McMahon SmackDown, shows up at Raw, and then he beats the hell out of Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Basically shows up at Raw after he's been off on an injury to come back and basically make a statement to all of the WWE on Raw when he doesn't even belong there. But, you know, this goes to show that what I've always known, SmackDown is just a little bit better than Raw.
And here's Hugh up. Oh, the ropes trying to knock down the 350-pound Albert. You know, that's like hitting a brick wall.
Yeah, and look at the strength of Hugh Morris.
Hook of the leg, cover on Albert, and Albert just gets the shoulder up. Hit the nail on the head, the strength of Hugh Morris. Chopped to the throat by Albert. A little bit later on, exclusive footage from this past Thursday night on SmackDown. You will not believe what happened, folks, when SmackDown went off the air following the steel cage match between Kurt Angle and Edge.
It was a pretty special moment.
You know, Kurt Angle made it through that entire steel cage match, as we'll show you a little bit later on. Oh, wow! What a bicycle kick to the head of that of Hugh Morris by Albert.
And to the head, you're right. Right in the forehead.
You know, Kurt Angle made it through that whole steel cage match with that wig still intact.
Get your ass
off. I'm beginning to wonder if it's a wig, Michael.
Oh, come on, Al. You know better than that.
It'd just be a really bad haircut.
Yes. Don't buy into the Taz syndrome that he's taking these hair supplements.
Well, I'm not that dumb.
Oh, look at this. Albert shoving Hugh Morris off the ropes. And Albert with another shot to the small of the back. And the big man is just wearing Hugh Morris down.
I mean, come on, Michael. I'm a little smarter than Taz.
Now, that'll be debated some other time. I'm not going to get in the middle of that fight as Albert delivers those left and rights to the midsection of Hugh Morris, face first in the center of the ring. A little bit later on, folks, the Reverend Devon's going to be in action against the Big Valboski. I wonder if Devon's going to be hearing any confessions this week like he did on SmackDown with Lance Storm Thursday night.
You know that man of... I don't know what to make of Devon Dudley.
He's a farce. He's a hypocrite. as Albert continues this abdominal stretch on Hugh Morrison. Albert using the ropes, which is illegal. That's a good move by referee Mike Smart.
Yeah, taking control, taking command.
I don't think Albert liked that too much, but he should have concentrated on the matchup, because here comes Hugh Morris off the ropes, and Albert knocked down by the big shoulder of Hugh Morris. And another knockdown.
The human Humvee on the roll.
Uh-oh.
Two big meat slapping mastodons.
Albert with the elbows to the side of the head. Oh, a suplex.
German suplex right onto the back of the head.
Bended Albert up in half, and can Hugh Morris take advantage? Cover, hooks the near leg, and Albert just gets the shoulder up. Well, what two youngsters received WWE contracts on Tough Enough 2, the finale this past Thursday night? We're going to show you a little bit later on as this youngster, Hugh Morris, comes off the top rope, driving the elbow to the heart of Albert. And Albert just gets the shoulder up yet again. How important now is this matchup for these two young guys, Albert and Hugh Morris, within Mr. McMahon's SmackDown realm?
Well, every match for every single person is incredibly important because it sets the pace.
Oh, look at this. Hugh Morris, top rope. What the hell is he going to do here? Out of the way.
He's got to pull it together. Can he bring himself back up off the mat? Can Albert pull it together and bring himself up off the mat?
Hugh Morris, you can see, really hurt himself on that missed moonsault. Hugh Morris gasping for air. Albert to his feet as well. Boot to the face, perhaps a desperation maneuver by Hugh Morris. Nobody home for Albert. Can Morris take advantage? Uh-oh, look out. Hugh Morris made one mistake into the ball go by.
Two, three.
And Albert picks up the win.
Mistake in 3 seconds, you're a winner or a loser.
I'll tell you, I think both men were winners in this matchup. Albert and Hugh Morris, extremely, extremely impressive here on Velocity this week.
Albert still feeling the effects of the match. He didn't get out of it unscathed.
What the hell's Albert doing now?
Yeah.
Albert is nothing but a 350-pound bully, but a bully who is taken to the brink here tonight by Hugh Morris.
Well, those grizzly bears can always be unpredictable.
Concept of spending a little bit of time with a guy that's not three times your age seem a little foreign to you?
You have no idea anything about me and Mr. McMahon's relationship.
You're right. Maybe I should ask Dawn Marie.
What do you mean by that?
Oh, nothing. I just saw SmackDown last weekend. It looks like you might have a little competition. See ya.
Meow. Here, kitty, kitty, kitty.
Looks like Tori's giving a little lowdown to Stacy about Dawn Marie.
Oh, testify!
How excited are those two kids? Brand spanking new WWE contracts.
They work hard and they deserve to win. But you know what? To be honest with you, at least all 13 of them, they all tried, they all pursued a dream, and in my book, they're all winners to come.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring, being accompanied by Deacon Batista, weighing in at 246 pounds, Reverend Diva.
You know, I gotta laugh every time I see this guy. He is an absolute hypocrite, this Reverend Devon.
feel slimy. I want to go take a shower.
And the Deacon out there carrying around a collection box. Well, Snickers Cruncher presents WWE King of the Ring. Hungry? Crunch this. King of the Ring comes to you live Sunday, June 23rd from the Nationwide Arena in Columbus, Ohio. And tickets are on sale for King of the Ring. They're going fast.
Yes, because it's in God's country.
Oh, my brothers and sisters, the Reverend Devon, along with the Deacon, has come to the great White North. Oh, yeah. Before I commence with tonight's sermon, I'm going to have the Deacon go amongst and collect for the Devon Building Fund. Because you see, I'll testify. I see a lot of impurity. Oh, I see a lot of fornication. Oh, I see a lot of sinners. Deacon, go out there and collect. You see, it is my job to bring you to the light, which I will, because you see, you're all so weak. And if I see it, then I know the man upstairs does. It says it right here in my sermon. Long is the way and hard that out of hell leads up to the light. Oh, yeah. So please be generous, because remember, a dollar today means salvation tomorrow.
Canadians don't seem to be too generous this week.
Building fund? I've yet to see a doorknob or a hinge or a nail bar.
The way you treat some person giving you their hard-earned cash.
Well, they are buying salvation.
You see, good people, the Devon Building Fund works on U.S. currency.
What?
So if all you got is that Canadian discount money, then I suggest you donate twice. Oh, testify.
It is the exchange rate, Michael.
Yeah, Devon not too happy with the exchange rate.
Hello, ladies.
Might not be happy with this guy either.
And from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing in at 244 pounds, the Big Balboski.
I like the Big Balboski.
I do too, especially because he calls Sin City home.
Yeah, we saw the Big Balboski this past Thursday night on SmackDown talking Edge a little bit before the steel cage matchup. Balboski, he's a real smartass. And that's the type of guy he is. He's a fun-loving guy. He likes to have a blast. And, well, Devon didn't like the showboat. And the Reverend Devon, with the right hands, took the Big Balboski as the ever-present Deacon Batista looks on.
Would this be what the Reverend Devon calls a laying on of hands?
Well, that's a good point. You know, you made another good point earlier, Al. Where's all this money going for the building fund? Well, I think Devon went out and hired some gospel singers for that tune that brings him down to the ring.
I'm on a roll. I made a couple good points tonight.
You had a lot of good points tonight.
Wow.
Ooh, I think you're all excited after that big Tough Enough 2 finale this past Thursday night.
Dang on right, I am.
Oh, what a shot to the sternum by the Big Balboski. And again, here are two young superstars, Al, who have the opportunity to really make a name for themselves here tonight on Velocity as part of Mr. McMahon's SmackDown.
And not just make a name here. Think about it. Reverend Devon makes a name here. He goes all across the country. He hits PTL. He hits 700 Club.
Just a reminder, Confidential coming up here on the new TNN right after Velocity. And tonight, an in-depth interview, part two of that interview with the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels, plus a look at the tumultuous life of Davey Smith, the British Bulldog who passed away last week.
Very tragic ending.
The referee begins the count, both men down center of the ring as the Reverend, I should say the Deacon Batista, looks on with that collection box in tow.
If he's a deacon, I'm a nun.
Oh, Balboski knee to the midsection. And Balboski battles back with the right hands to the Reverend Devon. Reversal. Balboski off the ropes, went for the hip toss. What a counter by the Big Balboski.
Arm drag.
Arm drag by by Valboski. And I'll tell you, the Reverend may need some salvation after the hurting that Valboski is putting on him here tonight on Velocity.
Well, will Devon be saved when we come back?
The big Valboski, Al, really putting a hurting on Devon, working those legs during the break. And look at the Deacon. And Devon's tapping out. Devon is tapping out, but the Deacon's got the referee distracted.
And Valboski let go of the reverse figure four.
And out from behind, the Reverend Devon. Valboski had this matchup once, but wasn't for the damn Deacon.
Damn Deacon, you can use such blasphemous terms of a man of the cloth?
Come on. Blasphemous? He's not even a deacon. He's a monster is all he is. But the Reverend Devon is taking it to the big Valboski. You know, got to give a big shout out to your buddy. Yeah, what a drop kick by Devon. Maven suffering a broken leg in that matchup this past week against Christian, thanks to that damn Tajiri, who was all upset because, well, his ex-girlfriend Tori seems to like Maven a little bit.
Well, what goes around comes around. I count on the fact that my boy Maven's going to have a little bit of revenge on Tajiri someday when he heals up.
What is Devon doing here?
Well, I call that bending him in half, Michael.
The Reverend Devon continuing to stretch the back of that leg of the big Valboski. I'll tell you, you got to admit this Devon and his Deacon make a formidable duo.
Well, apparently, according to them, they've got the man upstairs behind them.
Well, the big Valboski with the right hand trying to come back in this matchup, trying to build momentum, but Devon cuts him off with the pass. With an elbow under the chin. And here, into the cover goes Devon, trying to roll Valboski over. Finally does. Hook to the outside leg, and Valboski gets his foot on the ropes. What a matchup here on Velocity. We deliver each and every week as part of Mr. McMahon's SmackDown.
Yes, we do, because it is SmackDown.
I think Devon just delivered the last right, says that's all for the big Valboski.
Well, Devon calling out who's the man.
Well, big Valboski countered with a back body drop.
Apparently Valboski is.
And Valboski trying to gather momentum, trying to pull himself up as he tries to catch his breath.
Got to pull it together. Think on your feet.
Elbow to the chin. You can hear that echo off the jaw here in this arena. And Devon hung up on the top rope.
There you go. Get up off the mat. Heel, I say.
And big Valboski trying to make it to his feet. The Reverend Devon there as well. And Valboski with the right hand, taking it to the Reverend on Velocity here this week. Reversal. Valboski off the rope, ducks underneath the right hand and a shoulder block.
The Reverend feeling the power of the Valboski.
And there's another knockdown by the Valboski as well. And the Reverend Devon in all kinds of trouble.
Up, going for the neck breaker. Oh.
And the neck breaker.
I see the pull again.
Hook to the outside leg and a kick out by Devon. And the Deacon Batista looks extremely concerned outside the ring.
St. Peter turning him away.
Devon may have to use the building fund as a hospital fund if this keeps up. Look out.
Fisherman suplex.
The fisherman suplex. The bridge. He's got him. And Devon just got the shoulder up. This Reverend Devon, a hell of a competitor, whether you like his ideals or not.
He must have a prayer rug in his back pocket.
Oh, Valboski. Oh. Balance on the second rope. And Devon. Oh, what a neck breaker. The impact as Valboski bounces off the mat. Devon.
Two.
The cover. Got him. And Valboski again just gets the shoulder up. Devon, I don't think can believe it.
I can't believe it either.
Neither can the Deacon Batista. I think there's hopes of some sort of divine intervention here on the part of the Reverend.
Apparently on Valboski's part, there just was.
And Valboski with a right hand. Both of these superstars with a tremendous matchup on Velocity here this week. Shots to the kidneys. Valboski knocked off the second rope. And the Reverend Devon, top rope, missed with a headbutt. Can you believe the action in this match?
Come on!
Look at Valboski begging him to get up.
He's all fired up. And Valboski, look out, spine buster.
Two.
And oh, Devon again got the shoulder up off that modified spine buster.
What is it going to take?
Valboski can't believe it either. Both of these men have laid it all out on the line in this matchup. So much at stake. You know, Mr. McMahon and others are watching these two stars go at it here on Velocity.
Oh, hit the referee.
Valboski inadvertently into the referee. Kick to the midsection of Devon. Here's the reversal. And look at that damn Deacon.
Wait a minute. The hell's he? Oh, no, the collection box off the face. That steel collection box. The referee didn't see it.
One, two, three.
And the Reverend Devon picks up a sinful victory.
Here's your Reverend Devon. You are going to have to go to confession, Michael. You keep using that word in regards to the Deacon Batista.
Well, I am so sick of the way that Reverend Devon and his Deacon are picking up victories here in the WWE. What a night on Velocity, and it just keeps getting better. Don't go anywhere, folks, because Confidential rolling your way as this hour